this video, we're going to be talking about compound interest, what it is, how to earn it, and how it can make you a millionaire.
Let's get it. What is compound interest? Compound interest is the interest you earn on interest. In other words, it's your money making money. It can work for you, use you with stocks and shares, or it can work against you. And that's usually with credit cards and fees that you accumulate for not paying your credit card debt in time. Think of compound interest like layers of a cake. You have the foundation layer, and then you add another layer on top and another layer on top of that. And although it might seem like little small additions, over time, that cake starts getting very big. It's kind of how compound interest works. Over time, as you add money to your investments, those investments begin to exponentially grow. And over the long term, you'll see how big it really can grow. Say you have $100 and you earn 10% compound interest annually on that amount. 10% is the stock market average historically. After year one, you will have $110, which is just simply your $100 investment plus the $10 interest that you earn. After year two, however, the 10% interest is now calculated on the basis of your new balance, i.e. the $110, instead of the initial $100 that you originally invested with. So, at the end of year one, you would see that you have $110. At the end of year two, you would see this has grown to $121. And at the end of year three, you would see that your final total is $133.10. Although this might seem like just tiny gains, over time, it really begins to add up. If all you did was put one single $100 bill into the market at a compound interest rate of 10% annually and over a period of 40 years, that $100 bill would come out as over $4,500 with you doing absolutely nothing other than just simply investing it and letting it sit there for 40 years.
Okay, let's say we take it one step further. So you have your $100, but you have to add to it monthly. Firstly, where are you gonna get that money? So let's say hypothetically you're 21 and in a given month, amongst other expenses, you might spend, let's say $10 on Netflix, $20 on morning coffees, and maybe $40 on eating out. So that comes to $70 per month. So over the course of a year, that will equate to $840. And then over the course of 40 years, that would equate to just over $33,000.
So hold on. I know what you're probably thinking. Maybe I want to have those coffees. It's enjoyable going out to eat food, and maybe I don't want to stop those things, even if it does mean that I'm going to have $33,000 in 40 years time. Like, it's just not worth it. And you know what? You're 100% right. We don't want you to do that. But let's take another hypothetical example.
Instead of completely eliminating it, you just reduce the amount of coffee you drink, or you reduce the amount of times you eat out in a month. And instead you spend $50 on those three areas. So you save $20 per month. So after 40 years, that would end up being just under $10,000, which if you held in a savings account with a little bit of interest, it won't come out as much extra. But the real kicker is when you invest that. So if you start with that $100 and put in those $20 consistently per month, after 40 years, your investment will be worth over $110,000. But say you're able to increase that $20 to $200 savings per month. After 40 years, you would end up with over $1 million. Welcome to the Millionaire Club.
But remember, in order for compound interest to work its magic, it needs two main things: time and not to be interrupted unnecessarily. So, in conclusion, as long-term buy and hold investors, you should invest what you can, when you can, and do it consistently. The sooner and younger you start, the better. Sit back and don't interrupt the process unnecessarily.
Thanks for watching the video. We hope you understand compound interest and all the beauty of it now.
As always, let us know in the comments below if you have any questions at all, because that's what we're here for. We want to help you learn how to invest. And also, if there are topics that you want us to cover, make sure to also let us know below in the comments.
And also, hit that like button.
Hit it. And we'll see you in the next one.